out. That was interesting.
I saw you limping in.
Yeah, I'll be limping out as well.
Oh, bless
you. Yeah, it's all right. I've got another one. You know, almost identical, all the way around. And it's fun. I've never had a broken foot before. I'm enjoying the crutches. I'm enjoying the attention you get with crutches. Everyone moves out of the way and girls smile at you. And it's like having a little dog kind of thing. But in January, I go in and record a new solo album under the name The Ginger Wild Heart Band. And that's going to be really cool because I'm working with some of my favourite people. And because there's no Wild Hearts at the moment, and our bass player, Scott, has went back to America to sort out some family stuff, which is far more important than music stuff, it looks like we're on a semi-permanent hiatus. I don't know if we're going to play again. If we do, it could be a long time. So I'm going to go out on Christmas and play a lot of Wild Heart songs because the fans all seem to want to sing Wild Heart songs at Christmas when they're drunk.
Did you struggle to choose which tracks to put on there?
Not at all, because I didn't choose them. I couldn't choose which is the best and which is the worst is someone else's decision.
That's like picking between babies.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, you know. So I got my kind of business partner who runs the label with me, Gav. He chose the tracks, and he chose the tracks for the free download, which is 10 more tracks, different tracks. And I was just like, yeah, if that's what you say the best ones are, then I agree. I like them all.
What's your opinion? Because we were talking about the internet earlier and Skype and all that. What's your opinion on the whole downloading?
I love it. I think it's brilliant. I think just anything that shakes up this. I've been waiting for something to shake up this business since I started, because I started like, you know, post Guns N' Roses, where people were dropped after one album, and you had a bunch of money ploughed into you, and if you were lucky enough to get your second album recorded, you owed so much money you were never going to recoup, and you were always going cap in hand to some guy behind a desk to make some music. And I love now that it's also DIY, and the only thing holding young musicians back is educating themselves, which I've always been for, finding out what's going on in this business. Don't leave it all to your label, your manager, or your whatever, you know. Learn for yourself. And it's something I've always done. I started my own label, managing myself, and you know, we used to book our own gigs, but just learning how the business works.
How do you do that without not having a nervous breakdown from stress? That sounds like a lot of responsibility.
Well, some people aren't cut out for this job. If you're going to get stressed out learning, then you're going to get really stressed out touring, you know what I mean? Especially if you're leaving kids behind. So maybe you're not cut out for the job if it's too much, you know? Everyone would like to be in a band, and it's kind of glamorous to a certain extent, but it's a lot of hard work. And if you're not prepared to put the hard work in, you're going to be spat out soon anyway. So maybe get involved in the other side, in the business side, and make some money for yourself, you know? Because the business side is where all the money is, you know? You can manage 20 bands, you get 20% of 20 bands, you never need to get out your bed, you know what I mean? You just pick up the phone and delegate jobs to people. But if you want to be a musician in this business, you've got to really educate yourself. You owe it to yourself. You're a lazy bastard if you don't, you know? And lazy bastards get spat out of this business anyway. I feel like I'm a reporter on the human condition. And if I'm going through something and I write about it, someone else can go, oh, I'm not alone. And it gives it a legitimacy, if you like, you know, apart from just being like a vacuous rock star, ex-burnout, you know what I mean?
Are there any tracks in particular that people have responded to?
Oh my God, yeah. A song called Only a Problem I wrote when I was just really, really going through the wars, and I was splitting up with my missus, and I wrote the song. It was so personal, I didn't even want to put it on the album. And then it turned out really well. Some songs just record themselves and they just turn out great. So it went on the album anyway. And then I found out about a year after it was released that a guy got in touch with me, and he said that a friend of his was going to go and kill himself. And he said, well, if you've got, he couldn't stop and walk into this bridge to throw himself off. So he gave him his iPod shuffle or whatever and told him to listen to the album. And the guy apparently came to that track, and he played the track over and over again, turned round and went back to his friend and said, what is this song? It's just, I don't want to kill myself now. And when you hear something like that, that's like, it just makes you feel like I deserve to be doing this, because someone, if you can save one person's life, it's reason enough to keep doing it and not complain about anything.
Is there any gig in particular that stands out for you that really, really got you?
The last birthday gig, the last one at the garage. I was like, I can't believe this might be the last birthday gig I ever sell out. And then this one sold out. I'm like, oh my God, I'm so lucky. That was it. It was such a great atmosphere. I just didn't want it to end. And that's very rare for me because I hate singing. It's kind of like it's common knowledge amongst our followers that I can't stand being a singer. I've learned how to sing now, but I still don't like it very much. But when a gig flies by, that's when I know that the audience carried it. And that's a great thing about Wild Arts fans. They carry the gig, they sing and they dance, and it's such a good vibe. You know, I get one or two idiots, but they usually get sorted out by the audience as well. I don't have to do a lot, you know. So I'm just really lucky to have the people that support me that I have.